Your social media. Hello, welcome to Fan Park Live. What's your name?
It's Everyday Fame.
Hello, mate. How you doing? Good, good. 2-1 victory for Man United today. Martial still on fire. What was your overall views of the game?
This is the kind of team that you could be picking, and you don't. And we put in, probably the best performance of the season. You know, all these favourites were on the bench. And it's like, am I right in saying that Martial's now scored more goals in 8 days than Sanchez has scored in 8 months?
I think you would be correct, because I think Sanchez only probably got a couple for us.
So, how embarrassing. I wasn't Jose out until I saw the training ground stuff. But how embarrassing to have all those fans saying about... I mean, obviously, you get Alexis Sanchez, you've got to try him on the left. But to have... I mean, it was just embarrassing for him, really, today. I mean, obviously, I'm glad that we've won.
Embarrassing for who?
Well, for Jose, because basically everything that he's decided to do, drop Mata, not play Martial in his position, be, reactive instead of preemptive, and persist with Lukaku when he's obviously must be having problems off the field. Because, I mean, that header he missed was like, what?
But why is it embarrassing? The reason why I asked that...
One second. It all he goes on about is how good he is and 3 championships and all this crap. Oh, I've won more than any of the other managers.
But...
Again, I'm just saying facts here. I'm not having a go at him.
No, I know, but...
To chat all that nonsense and then... United putting a performance like that with Martial playing in his position.
All right. Unless you're saying that somebody forced Jose to drop Lukaku, whether he may well have done it. I said, unless you're saying that somebody forced Jose to drop Lukaku, it was Jose's decision. Now, we could argue whether it was it should have come much sooner, but it's not embarrassing for him to make a decision and it work out.
I'm actually talking about Martial having more than a run of games.
But it's Mourinho who's bought.
I think you're trying to cause some kind of conflict in what I'm saying.
I'm not trying to cause a conflict.
I'm not talking about Lukaku.
Okay, let me forget Lukaku then. But who brought Martial back in the team? Did Ed Woodward force Mourinho to do it? I don't understand. It was Mourinho's decision. Again, it may well have come too late, but why is it embarrassing?
What I'm saying is, this is something that he's not done for 8 months. That the whole world has been telling him to do. Do you understand where I'm coming from?
But why is it embarrassing? He's decided to do it.
Because although he's decided do it, it's embarrassing for him to chat the way he does about what he's achieved when the whole world was telling him to play Martial in that position, and then when he finally actually does it, Martial does what he's doing.
The whole world also said when we signed Sanchez, it was a brilliant signing, and it was it's what we needed because Man City were going to get him, and they were going to get growth from strength to strength.
Let me finish my point.
Additionally, when you sign Sanchez for the amount of money you sign him for, and the amount you spend on him. And you have to give him a chance. Jose gave him the chance.
I actually said you've got to play in there. But it was very quickly that all these people that you're talking about that said it was a great deal suddenly realised that it wasn't working. It disrupted the whole team and Martial should be playing there. Jose stuck with Sanchez and has now been playing long after 8 months. He shouldn't have taken 8 months. For this to happen.
Well, listen, every day. Can I say something? I understand your opinion.
Oh, thank you. Will you explain it to him then? Because he doesn't seem to get it.
No, listen, let me just finish. So, but what I think is a little bit. Two things within that. One, Martial, the Newcastle game, he was brilliant as an example, and he's been brilliant since. Martial started other games this season, the West Ham game being one of them, and he didn't have the same hunger and he didn't turn up and wasn't brilliant then. He started a number of other games after Sanchez joined, and he wasn't doing what we've seen from him today. So I understand your point what you basically said that I disagree with is if you play Martial there, he does what he does best, but he's played in many games where he hasn't done what that he's meant to do best. Now, I get the point that he should have been given, for me, he should have had more game time.
Definitely.
But what I would say to that is none of us are privy to what's going on in that training ground. None of us are privy to what's going on behind the scenes. And I think, again, when you've got a player that's refusing to sign a contract, I think that can cause problems and tensions. And equally, I saw many awfully poor performances and lack of desire and lack of hunger, what I personally saw from Martial. I'm really happy right now because it looks like a corner has been turned and we've now got one of our best players backfiring. Well. The other point I would like to make here, again, it's like I'm forced into a position where I feel like I've got to defend Jose. What frustrates me in life is when people do this. It's like, you've got to play Martial, you've got to play Martial, you've got to play Martial. He plays him, as an example, and then he's attacked for not doing it sooner. I saw this with Wayne Rooney when he wasn't scoring goals at World Cups. Got to score at the World Cup, got to score at the World Cup. Eventually he did, and then the goalposts were moved, and it was, should have done it sooner, should have done it sooner. Mm. And I feel like what you're doing here is, if Jose's got to make these two or three decisions, he makes those decisions, and then you continue to have a go at him for not making them sooner. Earlier. And I find that just a little bit disingenuous and a little bit disrespectful. You know, praise him for doing it. That's what you've been asking him to do. It's again, I don't even want Jose to remain at the club either, but he made the right decision in dropping Lukaku today. He made the right decision in dropping Alexis Sanchez. He's done the things that fans have been asking for. Mm. Okay, later than they wanted it.
Yeah.
But then they're still not happy.
He's
done.
Because I was calling for Lukaku to be dropped from last season. There was a spell when he went about one goal in maybe 12 or 16 games, and I thought he had to be dropped because it wasn't working for his own sake, just for his own confidence. He needed a break away from, you could say, the spotlight, and to get back into some form.